In this class, I want to explain about the remaining terms in the concentration terms. In that, the second term is normality, denoted by capital N. What is the definition for normality? Its definition also comes from its formula. See the formula for normality. It is number of gram equivalents, number of gram equivalents per volume of solution in liters. Number of gram equivalents by volume in liters. This is the formula for normality. See the definition for it. If V is taken as 1 liter, then number of gram equivalents present in the solution is called normality. So, how to define it? The number of gram equivalents of solute present in 1 liter of solution is called normality. What are number of gram equivalents? Number of gram equivalents is equal to weight of solute by gram equivalent weight of solute. Weight of solute by gram equivalent weight of solute. What is gram equivalent weight? Gram equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight of solute, gram molecular weight of solute by its n factor. So, finally, normality formula we can write as W2 into 1000 by gram equivalent weight into volume in ml. If volume is given in liters, then formula is W2 into 1000 by gram equivalent weight into volume in liters, but here should not write 1000 term. Why? Because here volume is given in milliliters, but here volume is given in liters. Now we can substitute gram equivalent weight formula also. Then W2 into 1000 by gram molecular weight of solute into volume in milliliters into n factor. Okay, this is the standard formula for normality. Let's see the units and its temperature dependence. Units and temperature dependence of normality. Units also we derive from its formula. Here see number of gram equivalents per volume. That's why units of normality are gram equivalents per liter. It is also called normal, also denoted as capital N. Capital N means normal. Normal means gram equivalents per liter. So these are the units of normality. How does it depend on temperature? See, in its formula also there is volume term. So it is temperature dependent. When there is volume term in the formula, it is dependent of temperature. How does it depend? See, normality and volume, how are they related? Inversely. And you know, volume and temperature are related directly. That's why normality is inversely proportional to temperature, just like molarity. Since volume is directly proportional to T, that's why. So, normality is inversely proportional to temperature. That means with increase in the temperature, normality decreases. So these are the formulae for normality. Just like in molarity, here also we discuss different formulae for molarity. What is the formula when percentage W by V is given? What is the formula when percentage W by W is given? Let's see those formulas too in this class. X percentage W by V is given, then what is the formula for molarity? Already I had discussed. See, for normality, normality is equal to 10x by gram equivalent weight of solute. In the molarity formula, I had given that now molarity is equal to 10x by gram molecular weight, but here gram equivalent weight. This is formula when x percentage W by V is given, we use for the calculation of problems. Secondly, if x percent W by W and density, also called specific gravity, are given, also called specific gravity, if these two are given, then how to find out the normality? There use this formula, normality is equal to 10xd, where d is density or specific gravity of the solution by gram equivalent weight of solute. So this is the formula we use when this information, percentage W by W and density, are given. Later I will discuss the problems about these formulae. Later I will discuss those. Next, dilution. Just like in molarity formula, here also for dilution, normality decreases with the increase in dilution. Why? There is volume term in the denominator. That's why if V increases and decreases. Dilution means increase in the volume. Addition of water to the solution is called dilution. So during dilution process, volume increases. That's why normality decreases. So on dilution, which formula we have to use? On dilution, we use the formula N1 V1 is equal to N2 V2. Here N1 V1 are normality and volume of solution before dilution. N2 V2 are normality and volume after dilution. So these are the terms before dilution. These are the terms after dilution. So this formula we especially use when there is dilution process. Now how to calculate volume of water added to the solution during dilution? So for that, volume of water added, is equal to V2 minus V1. Here water V2 and V1. V1 is the volume of solution before dilution. V2 is the volume of solution after dilution. So we can use some other formula also. What are those? N1 and N1 minus N2 into V2 by N1, or N1 minus N2 into V1 by N2. We can use any of these formulas to find out the volume of water added during dilution process. Right. Next, if two solutes, similar solutes are given, one solution contains some X solute, another solution contains some Y solute. If these two are mixed, if there is no reaction between the solutes, what is the formula we have to use? So for that, see one more formula. See, for two non-reacting solutes, what is the formula of the resulting normality? If two solutes are non-reacting, that means if you take one molar HCl solution, another one 2 molar HCl solution, same solute there, you can consider one more another solution, 1 molar HCl solution, some 1 molar H2SO4. If these two are mixed, there will be no reaction between the two solutes. That's why there we use the formula, normality of the resulting solution or mixture is equal to N1 V1 plus N2 V2 by V1 plus V2. If two solutes only mixed, we use this formula. If solutes of different solutions are mixed, then formula N1 V1 plus N2 V2 plus N3 V3 and so on we take. If solutions of similar solutes are mixed, we use general formula N1 V1 plus N2 V2 plus N3 V3 and so on by V1 plus V2 plus V3 and so on. But here we are discussing about binary solution. That's why I took this formula. N1 V1 is plus N2 V2 by V1 plus V2. So using this formula, we find out resulting solution normality by mixing two solutions of similar solutes or same solute. Next, for two reacting solutes. For two reacting solutes, what is the formula? There we use N1V1 is equal to N2V2. So N1V1 are the normality and volume of first solution. N2V2 are normality and volume of second solution. That means second solute. So here this formula is similar to that of dilution. In the dilution process also we use the same formula, N1V1 is equal to N2V2. But here also similar. For acid-base reaction, how to write? For acid-base reaction, how to write this formula? Similar, NaVa equals to NbVb. Here NaVa, these are the terms of acidic solution, these are terms of basic solution. In doing problems, normality, volume of acid will be given. Volume or normality of base we have to find out. Then simply use this formula. You know, sometimes normality volume of acid or base will not be given. Their weights will be given. Then what to do? Then how to solve the given problem? So in that case, if normality and volume of acid are given, but other side about base only weight is given and its formula is given, how to find out? Then convert this formula into weight form. How to? Already we have a formula. Normality is equal to weight into 1000 by gram equivalent weight into volume in milliliters. This is the general formula for normality. So from this formula, how to get N into V? N into V, how to get? N into V is equal to weight of solute into 1000 by its gram equivalent weight. So using this formula, we can calculate the unknown, the base, weight of base. So in some problems, what happens is, about acid information will be given in normality and volume terms, but about base, normality volume will not be given. Just its weight and formula will be given. So then how to find out the unknown term in this expression? So there use this formula. So this is the formula of for a solution, mixture containing acid base. Next point. Next, if acid or base are having same strength, different strengths, how to calculate the normality of the resulting solution? Here we have three cases. If NaVa equals to NbVb, that means strength of acid is equal to strength of base. So in this case, the resulting solution is neutral and its pH is exactly 7 at 25 degree centigrade temperature. If strength of acid is equal to strength of base, then the resulting solution is neutral, pH is exactly 7 at 25 degree centigrade. Second case, if NaVa is greater than NbVb, that means which is in more strength, acid. So acid is having more strength, that's why the resulting solution is acidic and its pH will be less than 7 at 25 degree centigrade. Third case, if NaVa is less than NbVb, then the resulting solution is basic. Resulting solution is basic and pH value is greater than 7 at 25 degree centigrade. Now question is, if the strength is not same, then how to calculate the strength of the resulting solution? Suppose if we use the second case, what is the second case? Normality and volume of acid, strength of acid is greater than strength of base. Now that means after neutralization, there will be acid. Why? Because strength of acid is more than strength of base. That's why after the neutralization, some acid will be left over. How to find out the normality of that leftover acid solution? So for that, we use the formula. normality of the resulting solution is equal to NAVA minus NBVB by VA plus VB. This is the formula we have to use for the determination of normality of the leftover acid when acid is having more strength than base. You know, this is equal to concentration of H plus. This square bracket represents what? Concentration. Okay, so this formula NAVA minus NBVB equals to VA plus VB, this gives strength of acid left over in the neutralization process. Similarly, if you take the third formula, here in this third formula, base strength is more than acid strength. So their formula is to find out the normality of the base left over in this process. Formula is NBVB minus NAVA by VA plus VB. This is the formula. Here, this is equal to concentration of OH minus. So, this is the formula to find out the leftover acid. This is the formula to find out the leftover base. So, in some problems, information will be given. Using that information, how much acid will be left over or how much base will be left over, we find out using these formulae. Next, there is another formula we use frequently in problems. That is, see, a reaction is there, A plus B gives rise to C plus D. In this reaction, information of one reactant or product will be given, other reactant or product we have to find out. So for that, use this formula. What is that? Number of gram equivalents or simply equivalents of A equals to number of equivalents of A reacted is equal to number of equivalents of B reacted is equal to number of equivalents of C formed equal to number of equivalents of D formed. That means in terms of equivalents, reacted component or formed compound are same. Equivalents of reactant reacted is equal to equivalents of product formed. This is the formula we use especially in reactions. Using it is convenient to use equivalent concept than mole concept. Why I am saying equivalent concept is more convenient, that in moles we have to balance the equation, but in equivalence concept it need not be balanced. So that is the reason. So always when there is a reaction, solve the problem using equivalence concept, not using moles concept. Next, here equivalence of A equal to equivalence of B. Next, what is the relation between equivalence and moles? See here, number of equivalents is equal to number of equivalents is equal to number of moles into its n factor. What is n factor? This n factor differs from nature, some substance to substance. This n factor differs from substance to substance. We have four kinds of substances: acids, bases, salts, oxidants, reductants. Total five types of substances we have, including elements. There are total six types. How to find out the n factor of each type? I will explain each one with an example. See, for that n factor, how to determine? Calculation of n factor means calculation of equivalent weight. See, equivalent weight, how to find out? Equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight by n factor. Let's see for different terms how to find out the n factor. First, for elements find how to find out the E means equivalent weight. So for elements, E is equal to equivalent weight, E is equal to its atomic weight by valency. Atomic weight by valency. See, for an example, equivalent weight of some aluminium, how to find out? So equivalent weight of aluminium, its atomic weight 27 by its valence electrons. How many valence electrons are there in aluminium? Aluminium belongs to group 30. That means valence electrons 3. NH2NP1 is its configuration. That's why 3. That means 9. Equivalent weight of element aluminium is 9. Similarly, equivalent weight of magnesium. Here, magnesium belongs to group 12. That means it is having configuration NH2. NH2 means its atomic weight. What is the atomic weight of magnesium? It is 24. So 24 by valence electrons 2. So its equivalent weight is 12.